Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Plado, aka Black Max Headroom. You on Pladovision right now, you know what we doing, we chilling. I got my cousin Lee in here with me, and we.
Yeah, you here? You feeling?
You know,
you really here though.
We're doing a little something today, just talking with the people, answering questions. We're gonna do a relevant, who's relevant. We're gonna take it back like a historic day real quick.
2004, right?
Yeah, 04. We're gonna talk about what was happening in 04, but we don't have Run DMC. Run's the hardest, man. He's one of the hardest, for real.
You know, it was a trip high in my heart. He came. He was like, I see you're a kill. So, you gonna step and level up. You gonna level up this game.
Run. Cold dude. DMC was nice. Run was on another level already.
Okay.
King Run's house.
Okay.
That's who's house is.
It's all his.
Yeah.
He's like the Lil Wayne of his crew.
I guess you could say that, and if you want to relate that to a today's thing.
Yeah.
Okay. But they were more of a group, like maybe. I don't even know. Who's a rap group now? Migos? I don't even know.
Yeah, Migos is a rap group.
They're a group.
Yeah, because like, you know.
I don't know if they have a prominent dude though, like nowadays. I think they're all probably on the same level.
They're known as the Migos.
Yeah,
they're a different group.
Even though, you know, it was Run and DMC and Jam Master J, you know what I'm saying? So they were three entities almost, you know what I'm saying? But, you know.
I would say G.
Okay, yeah, okay, right. So. Who's the hardest in G-Unit? 50? I hear people saying Lloyd Banks. I heard some Banks' bars retarded sometime. I heard some Banks' bars that I don't think 50 was messing with.
Okay.
But I don't know. I haven't heard 50's best, maybe. I heard 50 on a lot of stuff, but I haven't heard no mixtape material. I've heard all the radio stuff
that was
on the CD. But I've heard some mixtapes when I was in Charlotte that Lloyd was on murdering. You know, shout out my dude Jay Bird in Charlotte. You know what I'm saying? He was one who turned me on to.
He's gonna be banging hard. When he see that you give a shout out, he's gonna be turned up.
Oh, that's my dude.
He'll be like, yeah, I'm
on. My dude, dude. I love that dude. All right, that's my homeboy. He had my back out there the whole time, like, no matter what. Like, when I touch down in Charlotte, it's home on his couch right there playing the PlayStation.
And it's hard to have people that got you like that when you're not from the area.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you can grow up there.
Right. Yeah.
And that's his spot.
Right.
So he knows where to keep you safe.
Oh,
how
yeah.
to keep you safe.
Right.
And sets up a nice situation.
Yeah, we have some good times, man.
Yeah, that's what's up.
Shout out to Pladovision. Shout out to everybody out there watching. Shout out to Charlotte, North Carolina, Cackalack. You know what I mean? My dude Sway that puts it down on the music. Hey, my cutty got some beats, so get at him if you in the Charlotte area. Look him up, Slay Rap.
You say Slay Rap?
Slay Rap.
What's his Twitter? You got a Twitter or something?
I think it's The Real Slay Rap, but I know his Facebook is Aaron Slay Rap. So,
Like two A's, Aaron?
Yeah.
So when you type my dude's name, make sure you put two A's.
Get at him, because he got fire for you. You know what I mean?
That's what's up.
All right, well... Let me see, that's that Foxy Brown and Firm? What year was that?
Man.
You guys know? All right, I got a double XL. I popped a double XL out from 04 with Dre, with Game, with Eve, and Buzz.
Yeah, I was filming.
They was all signed for a minute with Aftermath, right?
I didn't know that. That's why they all of them together.
He had signed them all, so I don't know.
I know he had Game.
They never put out a whole CD, I don't think, though.
I'm on the five. Yeah.
We gonna flip through this. You know, we sneaker fiends in here, so this one had the Kobe's in it. '04, that's the sneakers that was popping at the time.
Oh, yeah. Not the Nike Huaraches.
I still got some of these. I'm gonna bust them out, too, so you guys can see what my dude Ill Will does to the shoes. And we'll do it before and after on those.
Hey, you know what happened? That Huarache, though, it didn't have an air bubble from the outside, but it felt so comfortable. You know, you run and you jump, or you come down, land hard, and it was spongy.
Okay.
Bounce back.
Man, I don't know.
Nice shoes.
Right.
He got a lot of trouble, though. Messed his whole,
man,
everything
hey,
up.
You know. It's rough out there for a young black athlete.
Okay, that is very true.
Traveling and doing what he might not
one,
supposed
one
to
can be
doing.
One can be targeted by their weaknesses.
Hey, My fans are, I don't even call them my fans. My viewers, the people that watch me know yeah. I'm a Kobe fan. Okay. I'm pro Kobe, so, okay. You know, I'm fighting with my dude no matter what. It goes down. Yeah. Kobe, Jordan had his ways and he did his things. Everybody, all athletes get into things and some of them get caught, some yeah. don't. So, you know what I mean? Kobe, we don't know what happened yeah. that day. I know I wasn't there, but I know the dude scored 81 points. You know what I'm saying? And I know he's amazing.
Against the Toronto finisher. Raptors.
He's a finisher of his work. You know what I'm saying? Yes, I'll give him the ball before a lot of people. Okay. Only MJ gets the ball before Kobe. In a tight situation.
All right.
In a
clutch all right. situation. Okay.
Mr.
Okay.
Clutch, the Black Mamba. What? Yo. Holler at me. You guys know. Hey, hit me with some hate, network. Because you know the Black Mamba's the Black Mamba. Even yeah. if he's old, he's still... The Black Mamba. Yeah, you know.
I'm not an anti-Kobe fan at all. You know? Right on, right on. But I'd say I rock with the Warriors. So Klay Thompson is my dude.
I love the Warriors, man. I yeah. do. I can't even say I don't. When I was a kid, Sleepy Floyd had went on a tear one year. I forgot who they played in the championships, yeah. and that dude like went nuts, murdered. I think he scored 60 something points that night.
Oh no,
Sleepy Floyd. He was, and then you had like. Tim Hardaway, you know.
Oh
what I mean?
Man, Chris.
Tim Hardaway, Chris Mullin, you know
Tim
mean?
Hardaway, yeah. and Mitch Richmond.
And Mitch Richmond.
It was balling.
They've been
oh,
good.
Oh shoot, man.
I respect the old days. That was at least something we had in California. Also, besides my yes. Lakers, besides the Lake Show haters.
Okay. Okay.
And you know, that's what's up, man. Yeah, see, Banks. Crazy. Look, see, we were just talking about Banks. Banks is in here.
Did you say Banks go harder than, right. than 50? And I was like, I think
there
50 is the hardest.
Banks was hot in 04. Mm-hmm. There go Face. Scarface was hot in 04.
Yeah,
who's
yeah.
still relevant? That's what we're checking out with this, too. So we might even call it that.
Yeah.
Jada Kiss was coming out with music in 04.
And he definitely was still relevant,
death,
right?
Always will be relevant. Some cats is always going to be relevant, no matter Regardless. Who hates. Yeah, no matter what.
Damn.
Cypress Hill was putting out new music.
Cypress Hill just dropped his whole mixtape. I was saying they both fire.
Oh, we might
got
listen
songs
to that
with Wiz. He got some songs with Wiz on they go.
This was Till Death Do Us Part. Shout out Cypress Hill, Cali. Yeah, that would be amazing man. If we could get one of them brothers to come by here or even to call.
Yo, I'm you sure they'll be down.
Everybody out.
I'm sure they'll be down because they like to hang out like how we like to hang out. They'll be very comfortable.
Man, that show is nice. I watched Be Real Show to Be Real Word. Show. Y'all seen Short on there last week.
What?
They're going to hold crew the G-Unit crew.
Oh, yeah.
They was putting out music in 04 and they was doing their thing.
That's one thing you never you had.
You know,
let me see. Commercial break, so we're going to go to commercial break. We're going to stay on film while we do our commercial okay. break. They just going to take their commercial break because we don't give them no props. Or, you know, no special credit. They don't know us, we don't know them.
I'm hella relevant right now. I'm in love.
Bus.
The cool, cool.
Bus. Oh, Bus stays relevant. He'll be relevant as long as his voice is still heard.
Okay, okay.
Let's see, we had at this point. That was Jaheim, and I'm not sure who this other brother was. Oh, Left Guns. I don't know. Yeah. I haven't heard Left Guns, but I guess they were relevant.
Hey, but big up enough. To you if you're around somewhere.
Right on Left Guns. He was relevant enough to be on this
Yeah, at
shoot,
that time,
so.
You probably still doing your thing right now.
Right, right. right. Let's see. What else was going down, man? I know DJ Caution is going to be hitting us up with some information about a DJ battle that's going to go down on Pladovision, so... He's going to give you the information on what you need to do to get your song or your set put right here on video. So we're going to do it with video submissions. So you're going to submit your video and then Caution and I think DJ Pawn Shop are going to be the judges. So stay tuned for that. I'll let you know. We'll find out.
So like you record a video on your phone, like doing what?
Yep.
Like your idea?
DJ said, I think it's going to be
DJ
more
set,
like,
okay.
yeah, it's going to be a DJ battle, but it's going to be by video submission, dope. And then Caution and Pawn Shop are going to yeah. pick who is the winner of that.
Yeah.
And I don't know what the prize is going to be.
Can they come on the show?
No
Can
doubt, they? Yeah. Oh, maybe man. That'll be the prize.
Hey, you know the Beast is a DJ. Right you know the Beast is a DJ.
Is that right?
Yeah, he be putting on shows. He'll drive anywhere.
Man, make sure he, man, watch the show, Beast. If you don't,
oh, man.
Shout out, get your submission ready and submit it, so.
Oh,
you can
yeah.
get down. Look, excuse me. Eminem was the topic of conversation. I guess they were hating on Cuddy in 2004.
Mm-hmm.
They're asking all types of questions.
Yeah.
One of them was, when will everyone stop hating on Marshall for being the illest MC out now? We've all said some shit that we wish we Well, it didn't say shit, but it's, you know.
Yeah, they would have said it.
Framed it's out. It's there. But wish we could take back, right? Isn't that growth? Don't bring down another human for being expressing himself. It's hip hop. Fuck. Okay.
Well,
that's how they felt about it.
That man. So basically, get off of him.
Hey, the dude is raw. Like we were talk every time we get in here because it's a hip hop show. Mm-hmm. We end up talking about the dude anyway because MCs, you know, are the topic. But if you talk some conversations that you talk about, you have to bring up. Just like basketball, you got to bring up Jordan and Kobe, or LeBron or whoever. But you know, the people you got to talk about. So if you're talking about hip hop and rhyming,
you got to talk to people that are relevant.
Constantly gonna come up, and
even compare whoever. It doesn't matter who's trending right now. So like, there's people that's trending right now. They on YouTube every day. But those relevant people, when they pop on this up on the scene, you're gonna pay more attention to what they have to say, or you're gonna gravitate toward them more than you would the person that it was trending 5 minutes ago. Because they're a relevant OG. Man, for real.
I just saw, I guess, Scarface had been trending last week, and I got like a whole bunch of inboxes of telling me to go check out his interview he did on, I'm not sure whose station it was, my bad, but
yeah,
it was dope. I watched it, and he spoke about the industry and about what's going on in it. And it made him relevant that quick, so I guess that's probably why he was trending already. And Face has been around forever. Like I said, he's one that will always be relevant.
Yeah, man.
As long as he still raps, whatever he raps is gonna be relevant.
I understand that.
This is what cats was rocking. Maybe I didn't have none of these.
Yo, Fat Farms. I didn't have, but they might be big on the East Coast though.
Maybe. You know, I'm just saying that wasn't my thing, but that's what they had in XXL. And you're right, that was the East Coast magazines.
They gotta push their products.
All right. See Project Pat.
Project Pat. Right.
Now, when I was in Charlotte,
yeah,
Project Pat's big.
Okay.
I even seen they had a little local TV show over there because they still rocking their local channels.
Yeah, yeah. And public access?
Yeah, public access. And I seen a show they had went in video, bro, doing his live thing. And it was wild up there, bro.
It was a party. Telling you,
hey, they was acting a nut.
Yeah.
Shout out Charlotte. Y'all know how to party for sure. All
right.
When the CIAA pops on, man, it's ugly. Shout out Charlotte. Man, I wish I was there to party with you some more.
Man, I'd never been to Charlotte before.
Man, I hadn't either before.
When you touched down, it was on.
Yeah, right on, man. Let's see.
So you was in Charlotte in 04?
No.
Okay.
No. I was in Charlotte in 2010.
Okay.
2010 through 13. All right, they brought it back on us too. They're looking at front pages. So
that's dope.
Africa Bambaataa, Biz Markie, Public Enemy, Redman, ODB, Nas, Payton Full, Eric B and Rakim, Ice-T, Power, Grandmaster Flash, and the Furious Five. Queen Latifah, Beastie Boys, and Big Pun, Capital Punishment.
Big Pun, man.
Now, we just had another conversation about the illest MCs, and of course Rakim was in there, and also Nas was in there, but and Big Pun was on my list too, so this is also, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, there's a blueprint to pure and true hip hop.
It's like serendipitous to your idea, with your idea.
You know, I mean, we're trying to keep it true, and that's where we're going to bring it to the roots and try to give a true example or the true story about what it is and help educate those that really don't know. And if we don't know and we say some wrong stuff, let us know and we'll make it known that we were wrong and this is the real way it went down. Or come to the show and rap.
So what you're saying, you're not elevating yourself above anybody. You're just a regular dude. Like, yo, if I say something that's out of pocket, you know, correct me, please.
Oh, yeah. If I'm wrong, please let me know. Let's advance. This is hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? Let me see what they got to offer. Uh-oh. West Coast with it.
Oh.
How does the hip hop world feel about Digital Underground? What do you think?
Oh man, I think people feel like Digital Underground really made a movement that created a following for a guy that used to carry packages for for a band. You know, Tupac was just a regular dude. He was a roadie. And Digital Underground is like, when you think of Digital Underground, you think of Tupac. So they mean something. They're relevant. Even though
they're responsible for bringing Tupac then.
Yeah.
Pretty much. You know?
So even though they may not be hot right now, you know, they I think they're relevant.
Their shows are when they were hot, were they respected like maybe other hip hop groups?
They weren't, man. They weren't, because if you are a sideshow person, you know, you have like an alternate personality, or you look kind of funny, you have a persona that's outside of the normal realm, you know, then people are going to think, you know, look at this guy, he has on the costume and he's having too much fun. Oh, shoot, what are you doing? No, you cannot put on, no, you can't put those glasses
man,
on.
Man,
you're not allowed to do that.
Hey, you know, I dig it, you know, and I think probably Nintendo Underground was one of the most creative rap groups at their point in time. They came unorthodox, almost like a Outkast before Outkast.
Yo.
You know what I mean? Them boys came doing their own thing. Humpty was Humpty, and he was wild, and he wore some crazy suits and all that. And Shot G was smooth, pimping, mellow, afro dude with the shades on him. You know what I mean?
And then Lenny B had that. Freak too.
Yeah, and Pac was just a wild dude. Pac was a little nuthead. You know what I'm saying? A little nut homie. And he had some other drive and ambition in him, but you know, that's what's up. We're taking it all around the map. I see Master P.
Oh, man.
He was on the
speaking of somebody that's trending. He was trending yesterday. He had to tell somebody off, like, not to talk about his girl Mercedes. Because, you know, remember that CD cover? Mercedes had her leg spread.
Which one, on Master P?
Yeah, Master P was talking to Charlamagne Tha God on the show. And he's like, yo, don't talk about her like that. That's a woman. I respect her. I mean, he was trying to say, why did you guys try to push that record that way? You know, so like sex sales. He's like, man, you can't even. He said, wait, back up, homie. You're not going to talk about her like that. She's not even here.
Well, look,
this is great.
Here's a funny, ironic thing about that, right? So, that's that, Chris.
Damn.
All right, but it's funny because right here,
yeah,
Master P is on the Step Your Rap Game Up. They got him in the little square. He's in the ring for Step Your Rap Game Up. So I guess his lyric that they need him to step up or was saying was, we play football, no pads. She got the cushion. I ain't Bill Cosby, but I love Jell-O pudding.
No.
Is that suspect? Cause
actually,
they
you know
got
what?
Him on the Step Your Rap Game Up.
I know what your point is on this.
That's relevant right now because Bill Cosby's
what the hell is going
in
on?
Trouble, but you know.